So we're going to modify this into a battery powered and wireless DMX RGB white power spotlight thingy, which can also be run off a USB power bank. Good ones, I can do an amp or two output. Or any other DC source, like any old battery. For, I don't know, several quid, 10 quid. The light itself is 10 quid. A mod, the components probably cost 10 quid. 8 quid for the wireless DMX. And 3-4 quid for the power supply module. DC-DC converter. These are the remote versions. They have a fan in them. Okay. Make a note that is fan, LEDs, okay. So, as another guy explained in a video, these are just a voltage pass. Constant voltage, not constant current. They do some clever thing using the resistance of the wires or PTWM or whatever. Anyway, so what we need to do is we need to measure the output of the voltage of the mains power supply. So let's see, that is plus, so it's backwards on this one. Yeah, backwards. So that is plus. Well, it's all going on the test meter, so that will take care of it. Okay, so, time to say goodbye to this cruel world and power this mains monster up. Final check if I get myself deaf. That's good. It works. Okay. Maybe I should use So, says 10.69 volts. Okay. And if we pull out the LEDs, so with no load. Say goodbye to the world again. White spot. 10.70. Okay. Yes. Okay, 10.7071 volts, which is what we'll set the power supply of the DC-DC converter to. Okay, it's now safe. I'm not gonna die today. One power supply module. Plus input. So clip that there. Check what the bench power supply is set to. 12, that'll be fine. This one is a buck and a boost converter, so it'll be it will adjust it. It'll take over less than 10 volts, like 5 volts from a USB power bank, or why is this not working? Ah. Explain it. Okay. So it's out of range. I'll turn it down to it gets into range. Ooh, that's high. We are turning it down to 10.70. Not enough count. That does not sound happy. Don't forget to make sure it gets enough current, otherwise the bench power supply will limit it too much. Settle. Then just very fine twisting. I feel it has to be quite exact because, yeah, this light is designed to work off a particular voltage. And I imagine there's a whole lot of precise calculations that are done. Because it doesn't have any, well, it has a very clever way of limiting the current, apparently, but I believe it's voltage dependent. I think I'm going to say that will do. Right. So now that is done. Do I reuse this cable? How do I chop it and replace it? Decisions, decisions. Maybe I'll do that. Well, let's just take this apart anyway. Should have the capacitors and the mains power supply should have discharged by now, but just in case, because I don't like getting shocked. Okay, that's done. So here's some plastic. These are actually laptop casing samples, which were in a skip. But now I turn them into something more interesting and useful to me. Big snip snips. So.